Hello everyone, I'm your instructor Benjamin and I especially welcome you to another exciting video tutorial lessons with BlabenSolutions. So in today's video tutorial, I will be walking you guys through a step-by-step process on how to create this lovely and amazing tri-fold wedding brochure. But before I kickstart with the video, if this is your first time in here, this is BlabenSolutions and I'm into the production of graphic design video tutorial. And I also provide graphic design services on other freelancing platforms such as Fiverr and Upwork. So do also check the description below for the link to my other page if you need any design work. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you've not done that yet, and also like this video if you find it interesting, and do also check my other videos as well. Without having anything to say, why don't you come along with me and let's start designing our tri-fold wedding brochure. Alright, so welcome back. Now, in front of you are the resource files that I'll be using for the design work. Make sure to check the description below for the link to the resource files as well. And I have some text in here that I would actually be using for the design process. Okay, this is a tri-page. That's a tri-fold brochure. So quickly, let's jump into the world of Photoshop over here. And the first thing we are going to do is to, you know, create a document. That is, I'm going to be working with an A4 size. So let's come to print and let's choose A4 in here. And I'm going to be turning the orientation to, you know, landscape. And let's name our document, that is wedding brochure. And the resolution is I'm going to leave it to 300, and the color mode as it is. And, you know, let's click on create. Alright, so in front of you is the document, that's the canvas that I'll be working on. And in my previous video, I taught you guys how to set up your guide. That is, when you're about designing a tri-fold or a tri-page brochure, how to set up your guide. So if you've not watched that video, there's a link up here, or you can as well check the description for the link to watch that video. But better still, I'm still going to, you know, walk you guys through. But that wouldn't be as detailed as the previous video. So first of all, what I'm going to do is, you know, get my rulers on. So if you cannot find your rulers in here, just go to the view tab over here. So come up here, view tab, and scroll down to rulers. That is, or use a control, the shortcut key control R to get your rulers. So I have my, you know, vertical rulers and I have my horizontal rulers. All right, so what I'm going to do first of all is, you know, to set up my bleed. Okay, so just come up here to the ruler, click and drag. You see a line, so just drag it and place it here, and come back here and, you know, let's drag this and place this one as well here. Let's do that for the vertical side as well. So, you know, I'm placing my guide on all sides of the what, of the canvas. Okay, and I'll be setting a bleed side of what, 0.125 inches. That is the bleed side that I'll be setting. That is, I think, almost about 3 millimeters. Now, we are setting the bleed because in most cases when we are going to print tri-fold brochure, what happens is that some portions will be printed off. Okay, and therefore we need to set up the safe zone areas where, even though when the paper is trimmed, we can still, you know, get our design intact. Okay, so that is why we need to set that bleed. And to get the bleed, I said earlier on, we need 0.125 inches to, you know, get our bleed. Okay, so now before we do that let's get to know the entire, you know, width of our canvas. So let's come to image and go to canvas size. And you realize the entire width is what, 11.693. Please bear that in mind, 11.693. So with this dimension, that is 11.693, what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide this into 3 equal parts, and that will serve as what, the divided side. Okay, I did this in the first video, that's in my previous video. So I'm going to, you know, fast forward this, and I'll ask you to, you know, refer back to the previous video and watch that for me. All right, so now I've ended up, you know, dividing my pages. That's the first, second, and third. Okay, so these are my three pages that I have in here. And now back to my bleed. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to be adding 0.125 inches to each of the, you know, to get my bleed. Okay, so to do that, let's go to image and come to, you know, canvas size, and we are going to add this to, you know, we're going to add 0.125 to, you know, the dimensions that we have in here. So quickly, 0.125, and always make sure this box is checked. Okay, the relative box is checked. So let me just, 0.125 and 0.125, and take notice of what happens to the edges of what the canvas that we have in here. So I'm going to click on OK, and you realize what we've ended up what setting our bleed there. Okay, so you can see the bleed that we have. So this, all this part serves as what the safe zone, and anything that appears here will be what trimmed off. All right, so back to designing. Now that we have everything set up for us, quickly let's now start designing. Now with a trifold, this is the, I'm going to name this as a front page, and we have the inner page. Okay, let me start bringing my resource files. So quickly, I have this background that I want, so I'm going to import this guy over here. And quickly, with the middle page, I'm going to change the color of the middle page. So I'm going to use a shape, you know, and I'm going to draw this way, and I'm going to use this color. I'm going to start working on this. So first of all, I have my text file and solemnization of holy matrimony. So I'm going to use this. So okay, let's copy this and save this first. Then with my type 2. Okay, so this is actually going to be copy and paste. So I'm just going to, you know, fast forward this portion, as in copying and pasting. And if I use any font style that is new here, I'm going to, you know, put a description there, the font style that I use, and it'll be good to, you know, go. All right, so quickly, let me fast forward this portion and get back to the action. So welcome back, and now I'm done with the, you know, the font. That is the main font page. I'm done with the designing there, and quickly I'm moving on to the middle page to do that. And quickly I'm going to, you know, group all these together. Then in here I'm going to bring the, I have a background for it, that is this, and I'm going to, you know, just place this guy on top here this way, and with my everything said, just hit on OK, and I'm going to, you know, clip mask this layer on top of what the rectangle shape that I have here. So just right click on it and click on create clipping mask, and I have this. Now this is too much. All right, so I'm going to change the blend mode to screen and reduce opacity to, you know, something smaller. Okay, so I guess this is okay. That is 8. Let me make it 10. And having this background done, what I'm going to do next is to, you know, I have this round swirl over here, so I'm going to be placing this guy over here. Now the purpose of this is, you know, I'm going to be putting the images of the couple in this rounded swirl, okay, and so I'm going to be placing it here. And with my ellipse tool, come to your tools panel and, you know, let's select our ellipse tool. So I'm going to draw with my shift key held. I'm going to, you know, draw an ellipse shape with the same, you know, background color, so that it doesn't look as if there's a difference in here. So I'm going to be placing this guy beneath the round swirl, and I'm going to, you know, shape it in a way that would fit. Sorry, I think I'm doing something wrong. So let me select my ellipse shape, and sorry about that as well. So I've held on to the shift and the alt key, so I'm just going to, you know, placing this guy over here. Oh, sorry, I didn't get that well. All right, so that is it, and I'm going to, you know, align this guy's. Okay, so that is it. And the next thing is to, you know, bring another thing that is I have this, but there is a text that I want to, you know, bring on board. That is just, so thank you, thank you all for coming. And so with my type 2 selected, I'm going to, you know, click and draw this over here, and I'm going to paste this over here this way. And let me change the type color. Okay, and I'm going to use this as medium. So I'm going to be placing this text over here, and actually be turning this text to, you know, applying a gold gradient on top of it. So with my, you know, add layer style select, clicked on, let's go to gradient overlay, and I'm going to search in between my gold gradient overlay that I have to see if I can apply an overlay of, you know, some gradients to it. Okay, so I'm going to apply this to that, and I'm going to be typing thank you with, I have a certain font that, you know, I have, you know, favorited. So and that the name of the font is Galantis, so I'm going to use this font. Of course, I'm going to apply, let's copy the layer style of this and paste it on top of this guy. Okay, so paste. Oh, sorry. So let's right click on this layer and let's say paste layer style. So automatically it has the gradient, and I'm going to copy this down here as well, and we are going to, you know, take the Mr. and Mrs. Yeboa. For the Mr. and Mrs. Yeboa, I'm going to turn the layer style off. I'm going to leave it as it is, and this portion is still going to hold the image. Okay, this will still hold the image, but then I'll be working on this first. So I have this nice, but let me say, edge that I would like to place in here. So I have this. Let me bring this guy to the next page. With my rectangle marquee tool, I'm just going to, you know, take portions of it and control X, control paste. So I'm just going to hold and drag this guy to my design. With that of these ones are going to be placed at the, you know, edges for me. So let me say I have this and I have that. So let me quickly send them, and I'm going to be placing this guy over here. So that. And we have to make sure it doesn't eat into the bleed side, because when it get trimmed, our design will be wrong. So there you have it, and I'm going to bring the other one as well. And basically we are getting closer to the, you know, the latter part of designing our Tri-Fold Wedding Brochure. And I currently don't have an image to place in here, but if you do, you can place an image in here. And quickly, to work on the last page of the front page, I have some, you know, text that I need to bring in, and these are the texts. So we have the order of photography. So I'm gonna, you know, bring in the order of photography, and I'm just going to, you know, drag and with my type tool, just going to, you know, hold, drag, and, you know, drop the. So I'm going to align this to the left and change the font color to this, and change the font style to, you know, where's Poppins? Okay, so font color to Poppins, and let's change the font size to, you know, about 10. Then I'm going to, you know, paste this. So if I still need a couple of big size, I'm going just going to, you know, increase the size to, you know, I think 12 is okay, and maybe I can make this medium. All right, so I'm just going to be placing this guy on over here, and what I'll be doing is to, you know, type the photography something. So I'm going to copy the Mr. and Mrs., hold my alt key, click on the layer and drag it back here, and I'm going to, you know, be using this. So I'm just going to type order of photographies. I'm going to duplicate this here as well. Okay, so there you have it. So let me hold this, right, hold, click on the photography, and Control J, Control T, and let's hold our shift key and drag this down. Good. And I'm going to change this to vendor. That is what I have there. And I'm going to duplicate this entire text, Control J, and, you know, hold my shift key and drag it down that I have. So quickly, let's go to our text, and I have this, you know, Control C, and let's go back in here. And sorry, that wasn't what I wanted to paste. So let's paste this in here this way, and there you go. So I currently have this image, I have my text in here. So all what the client provided me, I've been able to, you know, come up with the Tri-Fold Wedding Brochure. So guys, this is it, and this brings us to the end of today's video tutorial. I believe you've learned something new. I believe you've learned much as well. Please do also give this video a like if you find it very interesting and, you know, educative as well. And consider becoming part of this lovely and amazing family that we've got in here by subscribing to the channel and turning on the bell icon so you don't miss any of my future uploads. Until I come your way next time, that is still Blabbing Solutions, and see you in the next one. I'm out.